Hello there, people. How's everyone doing today? I'm doing fantastic. Thanks for asking. This is not my usual setting. I know that, and that is fine. This right here is a box of 8mm Mauser ammunition I got from Fedarms. For whatever reason, people like unboxing videos, and I don't really mind recording them. So we're going to open this up, have a bit of a first impression look, and see if this ammunition is worth anything. Now, I've been led to believe that this is remanufactured ammunition from old military surplus ammunition. So I doubt this stuff here is going to be all that great, but as long as it fires reliably, I don't really care how accurate it is, because I normally only fire within about 100 yards or so. I normally don't move past that due to my eyesight, and I just can't see beyond that. So, if I have not said already, this is 8mm Mauser. Let's open it up and have a look. These guys are the only company I know that glues their boxes shut versus just taping them. So this might take a little bit of sawing. Just peeled my fingernail back. That was a pleasant experience. Exactly what I want in life. Man, this is not gonna make it easy for me. Need one of those Russian spam can openers. This is almost as difficult to get into. And I tell you guys what, this is a stout-ass box, too. They definitely don't want you getting into this thing. I wonder why. The box is like reinforced with little strings throughout it. Make sure I'm not damaging any of the ammunition. No, I didn't think so. This is supposed to be a pleasant experience. Why? Why is it doing this to me? Alright. Well, at least now I can see the ammunition and where it's at. This cardboard is a lot tougher than normal cardboard. This is not your run-of-the-mill, average, everyday cardboard. Oh, we got packing peanuts. Hooray. I feel like that was a lot harder than it was supposed to be. But, like, they glued, like, full-on glued their box shut right here. And right here. There's no way. Yeah. There's no way I'm peeling that up. And their cardboard is, like, extremely tough. They definitely wanted to protect this ammunition, and they did exactly that. Alright, however, I do see the goods right here. Looks like I kind of cut into this box, but that's just fine. I don't really care. 8x57, Fedarms, 20 cartridges, full metal jackets. Looks like they didn't really know the grainage exactly. It's 175.9 to 197.5 grain ammunition. Alright, let's see. Mass bullet grams or grains, 177, muzzle velocity feet per second, about 2,500. This was made January 2019, I guess that says. It says party 119 store up, so meaning storage date all the way up to 422. Alright, well, let's have a look inside here. I kind of stabbed it, which is fine. Yep, that is definitely 8mm Mauser ammunition. This right here says 04 and 60. I'm not sure what that means because I'm not sure what country of origin this ammunition is. Not that it matters. Yeah, 0460. The ammunition itself looks alright. It's very interesting packaging that they got going on here, but I like it. Like, it looks cool. I'm glad I got the Ethiopian ammunition because now I got a bunch of stripper clips just laying around. This is made to be non-corrosive, despite the fact it's remanufactured ammunition. So we're gonna see just how well this actually works. This says something different. 39 of 04. Okay. Is that the week that this was made? The coloration of the lacquer on these things is also quite different. Like, this one right here is quite lacquered, whereas this one is quite thin. This one is 5904. This one is 6004. Alright, cool. Those might be manufactured dates. How the hell do you manufacture military ammunition? Like, or remanufacture military ammunition? Oh well. Let's go see how well this works. I'm gonna go bandage myself up first, but let's go see how well this stuff works. Because man, it is cool looking. This is steel case, or steel core and steel case ammunition, so that's probably why it was as cheap as it was. But with it being as cheap as it was, I didn't have any issues with getting a package. Hell, with it being non-corrosive, if this stuff even remotely works, it will be worth it. Man, these guys love gluing their boxes shut. Come on, you. Alright, here's another set. It's clean ammo. It's been stamped 8x57 ISFA 04 of 60. That might be the year of manufacture, month and year, but I'm not positive. 04 of 60. 04 of 59. There was one in there that said 39. Yeah, this is 04 of 65. This one is 04 of 39. I don't know. I'm not sure what component they're getting from the old ammunition to call it remanufactured. Is the entire case the old ammo, and they just threw in new primers to make it non-corrosive? I'm not 100% sure, so don't ask me about that.
All right, if I have not said this already, this ammunition is steel core ammunition, so it is going to be pretty hard hitting. I'm probably not going to fire at the steel target, just because I'm only about 50 yards away and I don't want to risk any ricocheting. That being said, at some point later on, I'm going to make a comparison video between this steel core ammunition and a steel core ammunition for the Mosin Nagant. I feel like that would be a lot of fun. If you want to be around for that, go ahead and subscribe to the video now. However, we're going to go ahead and see how well this stuff actually runs. No sense in buying ammunition, no matter how cheap it is, if it doesn't actually function well in the rifle. I'm going to be running it through this sporterized Car 98K. There's nothing real special about it. It's 1944 production. Normally I'm not a fan of sporterized guns, but in this case, I like the stock on this one. I mean, some people call it cheesy, but I like it. Alright, let me load this thing up. Just for the sake of seeing if this gun's going to explode with this ammunition, I'm going to load it with one single round. Whew. Wow, that is some loud stuff. Alright, where's our case at? There she is. Well, doesn't look overly pressurized. Primers look alright, no bulging in the cases, no cracking of any sort. The lacquer on it looks good. Doesn't look like we have any real significant damage. I see some slight scraping on the lacquer right there. However, that might not be anything. Let's go ahead and load up some more ammunition. Tell you what, this stuff's way louder than the 8mm Mauser I'm used to firing. I wonder why. Alright. It's not the smoothest stuff in the world, but what do you expect for the price range? Yeah, we got some slight scratching with this stuff, but other than that, primer looks alright. I don't see any unnecessary bulging, so I think that this stuff's going to be just fine for shooting ranges. Oh, hey, look, a bird. Hi, bird. This steel case ammunition, like I said, it's not the smoothest, so if you're doing any competition shooting, you probably don't want this, because it's not a very smooth action. Also, like I said, take heed, this is steel core ammunition, so you probably don't want to fire at steel targets if you're too terribly close to them. Well, you pull the trigger and it goes bang. So 10 rounds, no malfunctions from any of them. I'd say this stuff right here is good to go. All right, well, this dirt cheap steel core, steel case ammunition, not the smoothest in the world, but considering the price point, I'd say it's worth it if you're just gonna be firing at the range. I don't mind it, it was a lot of fun. I'm probably gonna get more actually just because of the price point, and it's perfect for what I'm doing here. Which is just blowing stuff up. I'm very satisfied to see that it actually functions halfway decently. I do have a 26 pound firing pin spring in this specific Mauser, so maybe if you're rocking original springs, it might not work as well. This right here is not necessarily an accurate representation of that. If you replace it with a more powerful spring, you'll probably get better results. Alright, well, this was a fun time. Seems to be fairly accurate as well. I managed to hit that bottle on the top in, what, two shots? Granted, we are only at about 50 yards, but this ammunition is more than accurate enough to achieve what I am trying to achieve. If you're trying to make shots out to 1,000 yards, probably not. But for gun ranges and a YouTube video, this ammunition is going to work fine. Alright, well, I had fun. This was a fun time, but it just rained. And the sun's starting to come out, and here in Florida, it is just turning into swamp humidity. Combine that with the massive surplus of mosquitoes that are just starting to fly absolutely everywhere. I can just see them swarming this tree. I'm gonna go ahead and get the hell out of here. This was a great time. If you want to support the channel, check out the Patreon page. If you can't support financially, that's fine. Subscribe, you'll definitely support plenty. If you have any suggestions on what you want to see me do with this steel core ammunition. One idea I have is to compare it with the Mosin-Nagant ammunition, as I said before. But if you have any further ideas, you know, go ahead, leave a comment, let me know, maybe I'll get to it. All right, I'm literally being eaten alive by mosquitoes. I'm fighting them off, so I'm gonna get out of here. You guys have a fantastic day.